Welcome back to How to Create a Timesheet in Power Apps. This is going to be a recap video of where we started and the point where we are right now. So I just want to show you quickly some things that I've added. You notice that I've added a client number and a supervisor. Now the supervisor shows up because I have a SharePoint list called employee, and I added a supervisor column. So Kathy Lewis's supervisor is Jake Hamilton. Roger Smith's supervisor is Barry Richards. So I simply have to click in here. I have a lookup that's looking at the employee SharePoint list at the employee name column. So if there's a value in the employee name column in the employee SharePoint list that matches the employee dropdown, then it's going to bring up the corresponding supervisor. Now if I go to the TBL time card, this is the SharePoint list that I'm going to save the information. So I included the client number column and the supervisor column in the SharePoint list. So if I go to the save icon, you'll see that the client number and the supervisor has been added to the collection. And this is my patch that's going to that TBL_timecard SharePoint list, and I've added the client number and the supervisor to the patch statement. So let's just add some data in here and show you how it works. So I'll put a client number, just gonna make up something. Say Tony Jones, supervisor is Crystal Summers, regular hours, so I'm going to need time. Let's say Tony Jones started work at 7. Went to lunch at 11, came back from lunch. At 12, left work. At 4, for a total of 10 hours on Monday. So I'm gonna hit save. The data has been saved. So I'll go back to SharePoint list and do a refresh. you'll see that that entry has been saved in a SharePoint list. So that's all I wanted to show you for this recap. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section. And thanks for watching.